I've been using Premiere Pro for quite a while now, and since its birth in 2003, Premiere has made leaps and bounds towards making video editing fun, intuitive, and easy. But even after all of these incredible advancements, one problem still remains, and this is a problem that I get asked about every single day. So in this video, I'll break down the three key elements that will massively improve your Premiere Pro experience. Oh my goodness, oh my damn. The method 99.9% of people are using is to export your videos in H.264 and maybe change the default settings a little. But there's a better and more efficient way to export a video which can make your render times up to like 40% faster. The secret sauce here is to use H.265. It's a fairly new codec which offers better quality and lower file sizes at the same time. And this allows us to drop the bitrate to like 7 or even 3 megabits per second, even on 4K videos. This lowers the strain on your computer and now is able to render the same video within 3 minutes with H.265 versus 5 minutes with H.264. And by having such low bitrates, you'll be able to decrease your file sizes substantially. For example, the H.264 clip takes up 1.2 gigabytes, while the H.265 one is only 70 megs. And in fact, I'm so confident in the quality of H.265 that I bet you can't tell me which one of these videos was rendered with my optimized settings and which one is the default H.265 high quality preset. You might be saying,
"This is the same video."
First of all, and second, I'll show you which one is which at the end of the video. I'm aware that H.264 still has the best compatibility out there, but if you're purely looking for fast exports or small file sizes and are uploading these videos to the web, you shouldn't have any issues with it, and it should be a total no-brainer. Have you ever had a project where the playback was so slow that you spend more time trying to figure out what the problem is by searching forums and Reddit posts than actually editing, and it sucks your freaking soul out of your body? Me neither, but let's fix it. A lot of times you see stuttering when you have a lot of effects on your clips. So one way to speed up the playback is to temporarily disable them. And the easiest way to do that is to click the plus sign in your program monitor window and find this effects symbol. Drag it somewhere here to have it as a shortcut. Now you have a way to disable video effects in the whole project within one click. This will disable effects such as lumetri color and distortion effects, but won't touch the scale, position, and all of that stuff. So you'll be able to see the most minimalistic version of your video. But you'll get the best playback performance if you combine this with the next trick, and that is to use Proxies are basically just a lower resolution placeholders for your high quality videos. How it all works is when you import your footage, just select it all, right click, select proxy, create proxies. You'll generally get better performance with less compressed formats, so I like to select QuickTime here, and ProRes medium resolution proxy here. Media encoder will render these clips out, which shouldn't take too long. Once that's done, again click the plus icon here, find this symbol and drag it to the shortcuts panel. Now when you enable it, you'll see it switch to the lower quality video. You can apply all the effects you want on this clip, and when you disable the proxies, these effects will stay the same, but now you'll see your high quality video again. Oh, and by the way, out of these two clips, this was the one using my optimized H.265 settings. Now, the thing is, even after learning all of these powerful tips, there's still one massive problem that we all make while finalizing our renders, and to fix that, you'll want to watch this video here.